Hi, now the second slot is over for a CET examination. Overall, the review for the second slot was that it was more or less similar to last time. Maybe a shade easier, but the cutoffs are going to be more or less similar as what was last time. Coming to the section-wise analysis, if you look at analytical reasoning, that is visuals, not very difficult, easy. Maybe few questions here and there which could take time, but overall the section was easy, could be solved. So sort of similar to last time, except maybe some 3-4 questions, 2-3 questions around here and there, that could be time consuming, which you could leave if you are not comfortable. Coming to the verbal side, verbal was on the lengthier side this time, so it took a lot of time to solve the questions. There was a new set of parajumble type which was there, but apart from that, almost all the remaining was similar to what was last time. So two sets of RCs, one was supposed to be short, one long, that's how it is. But a lot of things were highlighted in the RCs, and you can take the hint of the highlighted part to answer the questions. Overall, RCs took a longer time to solve and a little lengthier. And that unfortunately would take your time off from the other sections. Coming to the third section, which let's say is logic. Similar type of questions like last year, only this year some of the puzzles were easier as compared to last year. So last year, lot of puzzles were tough, but this year, I think out of whatever puzzles were there, there were around 3 puzzles which were tough, but rest were doable sort of thing. Moderate and easy, both. So ideally, whatever tough puzzles, it was advisable to leave it as fast as possible and focus the time on the remaining questions. So there was no input-output this time, but there were questions on syllogism. Syllogism had a lot of questions, but only written on it. But the answers and options were more clear, and therefore, you could make out the answers. Apart from that, there was coding, decoding, directions were there. So normal questions for logic were still there. So I think the non-puzzle logic could have been solved, except maybe a few critical reasoning questions. There were around 10 odd critical reasoning questions. A few critical questions were lengthier, which could be left. But I think apart from that, the questions could be solved. Coming to mathematics part, it was technically easier than last year, but it was also lengthy. Remember last year, Pond was tough and lengthy. This year maybe it was a little shade easier than last year, but it was still lengthy. So that means the number of overall attempts people would do would be less. I mean, it would not be very, very high. Because though the paper seemed easier, it was a little bit on the lengthier side. Coming to the quant part per se, there were 3 sets of DI. Unlike last year where there were 4 sets, this time there were 3 sets. One could be tough, but others could be doable. And there were normal other sets like quantitative comparison, mathematics, and number series, which was normally there last year also. So more or less the pattern for quant would remain the same. Only thing I could say was it was lengthy, but maybe a little easier than last year. So overall, the way I put it across is abstract similar, quant lengthy, shade easier maybe, verbal lengthy, so maybe difficult as compared to last year. Logic could be a little easier than last year. So overall, I'm expecting the cutoff to be more or less similar to last year, and that's how you need to predict. A good attempt would be around maybe 150, 160, around 160 would be a good attempt to go about it. So if you have an attempt of 160 and with a decent accuracy, I'm sure you have a chance of getting into JB. Right? I hope that helps. Thanks.